Hey guys, it's Erin from Earth Healer Movement. Here today with another intuitive yoga workout. So come and join me. It's a beautiful fall day. It's like mid-October, so 2024. And in this red scarlet energy today. Scarlet, starlet. So come and join me, heal your body from all the stress and strain of work and daily life. Okay, let's stretch up our arms to the sky and look up. I might be focusing a lot on neck and just wiggle out that hip and those rib cage. You can twist. So this lumbar area and midsection, and then the neck. And I'm getting like base of the skull. Because that's kind of hurting me today, and up in here. So let's reach our arms up, grab the wrist, and let's lean. And this is going to re-energize the cells of the body. Other direction. And get into an alignment so each side of the body is flexible, pliable, releasing toxins. Okay, let's sweep those hands down the legs to the ground to forward fold. You can grab those elbows for ragdoll, and you can kind of sway back and forth. Keeping your balance. Put those hands back down on the mat. And let's spread those legs wide. We're working on these hip flexors that are very important for mobility as you age. So if we bend this leg and straighten out the other leg, we're going to go into a lunge. Do the same on the other side. Let's go in the middle. And other side. Side. drop that knee down, and you can put both hands in front and open up that hip area. Lift up, other side. Knee down. Down on those elbows. Okay, let's straighten that front leg. Sit back on that heel. Just do modify the movements according to your body. Tabletop pose and sink that spine inward for cow. Rock up and back, side to side. And now let's go into cat. So round the back upward. Back down to cow. Now drop down to the forearms. We're going into puppy pose. Rock forward with those hips onto the ground. Do upward facing dog. And then we're going to sit back to puppy. Do that again. And back to puppy. I'm hearing cleaning out the lymph system. The lymph nodes, if they're clogged, then they, I'm hearing bring inflammation to into the body.
So your immune system won't run properly. Turn to the left. Back to puppy. Sit back on those heels for, put your knees together for a child's pose. This is extended child's pose. Take a deep breath in and out. You want to use that full lung capacity. Make room. Put those hands around the sides for child's pose. Relax. Relax those shoulder blades, curving around your knees. Knees into chest. And breathe. Stretch out those arms. Slide along the top of the mat to go into upward dog. Down on those elbows, we're going into baby cobra. Turn and look to the side, flip that leg up. Other side. Okay, we're gonna do that again, but grab the foot. Other side. All the way down. grab the foot. Other side. Okay, other side. Lift up both legs and do it on both sides at the same time. Chin up off the ground. You can lift up your chest off the mat and your knees off the ground. Do that a couple times. I'm hearing helps with poor digestive issues. So go up on the forearms like this. Head back. Tilt your head to the shoulder, chin to shoulder. You should feel this in your right glute if it's tight, like me. And just hold it. And wait for the pain in your glute to release. Breathe into it. Real deep breaths. Until the pain goes away. Feel the stiffness in your neck, the pain release. Other side. Deep breaths. Both legs up. Breathe into the pose. Head up, chin up. Point those toes. Flex those feet. Breathe in, breathe out. Release those legs. Up on the forearms and hips back. Spread those knees and sit back towards the heels. Thank you. go forward with those knees wide and down to the mat. And let's go back to downward dog. Okay, let's lift up, knees together, sit back on the heels. We're gonna lean back. Put our head back, opening up that throat chakra, getting a good stretch on the base of the neck. You can try to rock your head a little bit. Massaging out any tension knots in the base of your skull. Stay on one side and the other. Up on those knees. Okay, reach down towards the heel and up with the other arm. Touch the heel with your fingertips if you can, and look up towards your fingers. Another good stretch for digestion and lymph node drainage. Other side. Pushing that pelvic bone forward, creating a curvature in the back is what we're trying to do. When we sit, it flattens out our pelvic. It tilts it forward, and what we want to do is like get that curvature back. So you could even go like this. We're gonna do a counter stretch, so we're gonna go on all the way down to the mat and flatten that back onto the mat, bringing our knees up towards our chest and pulling those knees with the hands towards our chest. Cross one knee in front of the other, and we're gonna pull on those ankles towards our chest, and we're gonna get a good stretch in the hamstring. I'm hearing these things like the lymph node drainage and the hamstring. So this is just my intuition guiding me. So feel free to fact check me feels really good. You can release that and bring that heel onto the top of the knee, and we can go through there, clasping our fingers together and gently pull forward with the knee towards the chest, and you'll feel a good stretch there as well. And you can even rock that back and forth to get like a massage on your lower back, lumbar, and hip joints. Okay, let's drop that knee or that foot down, putting the other leg on top and grabbing those ankles and bringing them forward towards the chest, towards the body, the upper body. Take some deep breaths in and out. You can try to grab that bottom knee and just try to hug those knees in towards the chest. And you're gonna feel it in this left glute right in here. And up your thigh. The inner thigh. So let's go on the other side and do that. Okay, separate those legs and grab the feet to butterfly pose. Try to extend those butterfly wings down and up and down and up, down and up, down and up, down and up, down and hold it. Down, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and up, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Release those legs. Bring those knees towards the ground, holding it with your hand. Extend those legs out and grab the thigh, the top of the thigh, near the knee. And bring those calves.
flexing those feet. And now extend out, pointing those toes, flexing and bringing the feet in, lifting up with those thighs, and now extending out, pushing outward, now flexing in, pushing out. So that's like a frog motion. That's so funny. And that's working your inner thigh area and your hip flexors. That's a new intuitive movement that I haven't done before. Okay. So happy baby is right here. So taking these peace fingers, wrapping it around your big toe, and you can rock back and forth. Another thing you can do is extend one leg at a time. And then rocking to that side on that shoulder. So you're also getting a massage on the shoulder. Bring those knees together, lift those both those legs up in the air, holding on to those shins. You can grab the big toes or the foot and stretch out the lumbar this direction, and your thighs and your calves. You can bring those legs out to the side if you can and rock back and forth. So this is like an extended happy baby. You can grab those legs if you can't grab the toes and rock back and forth. Bringing those legs in, putting your hands under your tailbone, lifting those legs up towards the sky, and butterflying those legs out, and then bringing up towards the sky. This is actually a Pilates movement. We're gonna do 10 more. You're going for muscle fatigue in that area. Let's lean to the side with your legs. Back.
center. Now lean to the other side. Center. Lean to the left. Center. Lean to the right. So this is working on your core muscles, core strength. I'm hearing obliques and hip flexors. I don't know if the obliques are the sides of your abs. You can rock those back and forth and kind of go like down and up, like a smiley face in the sky. Okay. Let's go to the right. And we're going to go upward. So we're making a rainbow this time. So we're going up and down. And feel the difference of that movement in the hips. And I've never seen these done before. A lot of these movements I've never seen done before. You can even make a larger rainbow. You can make a bigger smiley face. So you can make a huge smile if you go all the way down to the ground and up. How happy do you want to be? How happy? Or do you want to be super happy? Okay. How big do you want your treasure to be at the end of the rainbow? Let's make a large rainbow. All the way up and all the way down. Okay. Let's butterfly those legs out. Nine, 10, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And grab those feet and bring it towards the chest. If you can, you can lift up a little bit and rock up onto your sits bones and hold this here for balance and try to suck in your stomach and push out your chest and breathe. Side to side. I'm hearing like a jet fighter. Like one of those simulators. Okay. Put those knees together and go into boat pose. So you can hold on to those legs and boat. And extend those legs out and in, out and in, or you can put the hands out to the side. side and do it. Bring those knees into the chest. Flex and point those feet. And feet down to the ground. Putting those knees out to the side. I'm going to turn around. And extend those arms out to the front. Take those deep breaths. Other leg out. Both legs out. Point those toes. Try to bring the torso forward. Open up those legs forward like this and lean. Over to one leg. And then the other leg. And I'm hearing to really notice the way that your body feels. So when you keep doing it, you're going to notice better mobility and less soreness and pain. You shouldn't be experiencing like real pain, just kind of like tenderness, soreness. You're going to the point just before just as far as you can go without injuring yourself. heels, I mean, knees toward the chest. Extend that left arm out and bring the knees over towards the other direction, towards the right. So you're stretching this, I'm hearing rotator cuff in the shoulder, and your back, and your lumbar, your spine. Clearing out toxins and lymph nodes. Other side, so we're just gonna switch. See which side is worse. This side is worse for me. So there is some pain right here in the sciatic nerve pain. Just kind of like feel that area that's in pain and just kind of rub that. You can straighten that front top leg. And that's right in the spot right here of your sciatica. Okay, let's roll forward and do that again to the other side. Extend that leg out. Breathe into the stretch. Okay, come back forward, and we're gonna grab those toes and do that happy baby here. You can do that extension of like the frog thing. just kind of grab those feet and roll. And like just roll to one side if that feels good on your back and just kind of hold it there. Other side. Back front. Set those knees down to the mat. Hands under your glutes. Relax in this pose. Lift your glutes up off the hands. You can even sway it back and forth, back down. And again, lift up. And lift those arms up. Squeezing those glutes. Back down on those hands. Bringing those knees up towards the chest. Crossing those ankles. Extending those legs out and back in. Knees together, feet down towards the mat, knees all the way together, feet together, and do a bridge pose here. So lifting up your hips off of your hands, you can extend those arms and roll those shoulder blades in. So this is more of a bridge extension. And put those knees together and then go down to the mat. Sway those legs back and forth and release those hands from under your glutes. Tailbone. And this is windshield wipering your knees back and forth, stretching those hips. Okay, let's roll over to the side. Resting your head on your hand or your
or even all the way down to the mat on your shoulder. You can lift that leg up, the top leg, and grab it if you can. If you have a strap or a belt, you can wrap that around your leg and hold it. Bend that knee and bring that leg back, pelvic bone towards the front. And then back up again. And do that again, where you bring that leg back. Now we're gonna bring that knee forward and grab the other side of the foot and lift it up. So this is helping out the sciatic nerve. And then back again. And then forward. And then back. Now we're gonna do leg lifts here, so let's start. Eight, nine, ten. Let's do five more. Five, four, three, two, and one. Hold that leg up. Bring that foot towards the front with the knee bent. Holding that ankle, and let's lift that bottom leg up for 10 or 15. Hold that leg up and release. Let's turn around to the opposite side. And sit towards the back edge of the mat, grabbing that knee, the top of the foot, and putting that knee back. Okay, now let's lift that leg up and grab the foot or the strap. Bend that knee and bring it back. Pelvic front. Okay, now let's bring that knee forward. Grab the other side of the foot and bring it towards your torso. Oh. I was hearing like releasing cortisol, the stress hormone. And that's what gives you like a bigger belly, chubbier face, is holding in stress. So you need to release those toxins and the buildup in your lymph node system, your immune system. Okay, you can bring that knee forward again. Lift that foot up. Let's go up once again. And then let's start doing those leg lifts. Five, four, three, two, and one. Grab that foot or leg or strap. I got a fly in my eye. Keeps going in my face. Get away from me. That was crazy. It kept going in my face. I think it likes my red lipstick. Okay. This is a mermaid. Right here where you stretch over. In the opposite direction. You can go elbow to the ground and stretch over. Try to suck in that stomach. Other side. Lift up the torso. Hand up, head up. Switch sides. Elbow to the ground. And reach, stomach in, look towards that hand, okay, other side, stomach in. I've been trying to like be more conscious of like sucking my stomach in, like when I'm in the car, like driving, if I ever remember, but trying to hold my stomach in, so that will like strengthen the core muscles just by trying to suck the stomach in and chest up, chin out. Reach those arms overhead. And let's reach both those arms over. And other side. This might be harder. So you can just go like this. together in butterfly. And we're gonna lean over those legs, pressing those knees down towards the mat. There's a lot of tension in the back of my lumbar, lower back area, and my hips. So let's put our neck over to one side. So ear to shoulder. Put that arm behind the back. Other side. Other side. Now let's look towards the armpit. Other side. Okay, let's go on to tabletop and drop down to the forearms into puppy pose. Try to sit back on those heels and resist with the hands.
up to downward dog, so just go up on those toes, lifting those hips up in the air. Bend those knees for walking the dog. Stepping forward to forward fold. Lifting those arms up towards the sky. Into mountain pose. Shoulders back, chest out. Stomach in. Head up. Let's put the front leg back, twist that body towards the front leg, lifting those arms up to the sky for warrior one. Arching that back. Going into warrior two. And warrior three. Reverse warrior. Warrior two. Side angle stretch. Looking towards that palm. Hand behind your back. Bringing that other arm towards the ground. That's what I was hearing. This is kind of like a triangle pose. So lift that other arm up for a triangle if you can. Shoulders back. Release that arm down to the ground. Go into a lunge. Bring the other leg back to downward dog. Lift up on those toes. Lift the heels up off the mat. And then go down, bring those feet front for forward fold. We're gonna turn around, go to downward dog, facing the other direction. Lifting up on those toes. Walk that dog. lifting those feet up to the top of the mat into forward fold. Half lift, hands on shins, flat back. Releasing into your forward fold. Towards the front, the foot towards the front. We're going to bring both arms to the front and then up. I meant like to the side and then up. Bending that front knee. So I can feel that like strengthening my core. The warrior pose, warrior one. This is warrior two. Just this stance right here is really good. And the arm positions as well. Let's go back to reverse warrior. Warrior two. Let's do that side angle stretch. Straightening that leg and bringing the other hand to the ground. Other hand up in the air. This is a triangle pose. Look towards the top palm. Head apart. You can go down to the mat on your forearms if you can, spreading those legs. That's a little bit too difficult, I think. So you can try to get those legs closer together. One hand in the front, other arm up towards the sky. Switch hands. Okay, let's just do some balancing poses here. We're almost done. So, right leg up on the other thigh. Whoops. Okay, try that again. Find a trysty point that you can look at that you won't fall over. And bring the hands to heart center and up. Anywhere along the leg, you can put your foot except for the knee. Hands out like a tree, leaves of a tree. And you can rock side to side. And down. Other side. Hands to heart center. Up. Hands out like leaves of a tree.
branches of a tree, and you kind of go side to side. Okay, swaying in the wind. Okay, let's ragdoll those arms across the body. Stretching out those shoulders and those hips. Okay. Namaste. The inner light in me honors the inner light in you. Thank you so much for joining this yoga practice. If you want some other meditation after this, just like laying down and breathing, you can do that. And I'll show you the pose that you would do. So you would just lay down doing the corpse pose and just rest here. Breathing deeply in and out. You're like feeling the tension in your body and like releasing it with your breath. So note those parts of the body that have a lot of tension and stress still. You can release it with breath and drinking water with intention of healing that area. Okay, let's bring that leg up towards the sky. You can hold a strap, keeping the other leg on the mat if you can, or bringing it up. If you can grab the toe, go ahead and do that. Releasing the other leg towards the mat if you can. And you can bring that leg over out towards the side and look over the opposite direction. Bringing that leg up and over to the other side, bending that knee, twisting that back. You can extend that leg out if you want. Thank you.
I thought we were done, huh? Don't get me started with exercise. Other leg up. Bring that other foot up. Grabbing that foot. Try to bring the other leg down and extend that leg to the side. Bending that knee and bringing it over to the other side. And really take note of how your body is feeling and where the stress and the pain and the soreness is in your body. And as you do these videos over and over again, maybe give yourself a day or two in between. So you can get used to it, so your body can get used to it. Make sure you're drinking a lot of water to flush out those toxins. You can butterfly those legs here. Bringing the hands over your head, hands into a diamond shape. Lift up. That sounded like a bird or a oh, it's a squirrel. That's what I thought. Squirrel. And rotate those knees around and give you a nice back massage. Lower back massage. What are you looking at? Huh? There's a squirrel looking at me. Hey, we can roll up. Try to end this video out again. This is actually the proper seating position to end out the video. So let's go into lifting up and into heart center. Up and heart center. So namaste. The inner light in me honors the inner light in you. Have a wonderful day. And I hope
body is healing fast and releasing those toxins as you drink water. And your body starts feeling better and healthier as each day goes by. I'll see you next time. Have a great day, guys. Bye.